Hello fellow YouTubers, in this video I'm going to show you how to install two graphics cards into PC and enable SLI mode. Now for that you'll need two identical graphics cards. Now guys, I don't mean the same looking graphics cards, I mean that they would be NVIDIA first of all for SLI. For Crossfire, if you want to do, you need an AMD graphics card. So in this case, SLI means you need two NVIDIA graphics cards with two same GPUs. In this case is GTX 560 Ti and GTX 560 Ti. Now the graphics cards are actually identical, but doesn't mean for your setup that you need identical graphics card, as in same manufacturer, anything like that. Not at all. As long as they are both the same GPUs, they should be working in SLI mode, no problem. Okay, so we have two graphics cards and obviously my PC over here. I'm gonna open up the PC, just give me one sec. There we go. Now to prepare your computer for SLI configuration, first you need to make sure that your power supply unit is capable to run two graphics cards. For that you can go to, if I'm not mistaken, GeForce.com or Nvidia.com and just find the links for what power supply is recommended for two GPUs. Usually the rule of thumb is your system consumes around 150 watt max, well depending on the CPU and how many peripherals, but in my case let's say two hard drives, an SSD motherboard with all 4 RAM slots filled and non-overclocked CPU, Intel Core i5 3570K. That would consume about 120 watt max, I'd say. So let's say 150, just to give it a little bit of more headroom. And then add your each graphics card's wattage, what is manufacturer is claiming, and you'll have minimum PSU recommended. And as always, try to allow yourself about 10% or 15% above that for the power supply. So in my case, I have a power supply well above that recommendation. You can see the power supply that I have in my other videos. So, okay, we're gonna go with the installation. Now, before I install, I'm just gonna explain to you quickly how it works. So you have two 16X slots on the motherboard. So we're gonna use them for the graphics cards. Now, in this case, I have a very small computer case. So the SLI is gonna be a bit limited in terms of the airflow, because graphics cards are going to be very tight. It's not recommended, guys, and especially for the small case like that where the airflow is very limited, not recommended to go with SLI due to the heat and things like that. But I'm just going to go for the benchmarking purposes, and I just want to show you how to enable SLI and all that. Now in my case, the computer chassis is inverted, so you might have a different configuration. In either case, you just install two graphics cards in 16X slots. You can refer to your manufacturer's recommendations. And I'm just gonna install it first. I actually forgot to mention one thing to you guys. Make sure that you have, if you have a power supply, modular power supply, which I do, make sure that you have all the cables connected before you do any installations, because it could be cumbersome, especially in a small case like mine. I already have them. Now for these particular graphics cards I need two each, so there's two, and I also have another two for this graphics card, so I have enough power there to power them both. Now I'm just gonna remove these brackets quickly. Okay, and second card installation is exactly the same. When I'm saying not enough airflow, I don't mean that your graphics card is gonna suffer catastrophic damage if you're gonna run it in SLI in this case, or even smaller one, but as a precaution, it's just recommended to have a bit more room for SLI configurations, because graphics cards are one of the hardest components in PC, and you do need to cool them, so you need to have some space where basically air runs through the case and cools your components down. So that's what I mean, guys. Here is half a centimeter max between the PCB of the chocolate graphics card and the cooler. Now, I'm gonna watch the temperatures later if I can configure, if I can find what ASUS has to offer in terms of monitoring for an SLI for two graphics cards. And you can see my benchmarks in my future videos. But I simply would not recommend to run SLI in a small case like that, unless you're in desperate need of power and on a tight budget, or you got one graphics card or two graphics cards for very little money. So right, that's the graphics card installed. Now, for this motherboard, you have a very nice SLI bridge to connect the two graphics cards, because that's how the SLI works. Now I'm gonna use this particular bridge, which I got with a graphics card, I think GTX 570 or something like that before. So I'm just gonna use that, just for the ease of it, guys. And not an ideal scenario, obviously, because, well, because simply the color is different, but since I have it, why not use it? Okay, so that's pretty much it. That's your two graphics card installed, connected with the SLI bridge. And next, I'm gonna see you in a sec, and I'm gonna show you how to configure them through the NVIDIA driver, just to make sure that SLI is enabled in Windows. Right, guys, so in Windows first, obviously, when you switch on your computer, you install your NVIDIA drivers if you haven't done so before. Next, you go into NVIDIA control panel, and then you have configure SLI surround and PhysX. Now, if you have a newer driver, all the driver could be different modes, but in this particular driver is like that. So I'm sure you can find a similar option in your driver that you're using. And you do maximize 3D performance, select that, apply, and you set. Okay, guys, so yeah, that's it. That's basically done here with this video. Just wanted to show you guys how to install the two graphics cards and how to make them work into SLI configuration via NVIDIA drivers. Now, for more thoughts about the SLI configuration, whether or not I would use it myself, you'll have to watch the next video, which is going to be the benchmark of GTX 560, GTX 660, Ti, sorry, both models are Ti, and GTX 560 Ti in SLI mode. And you can see for yourself what our results like, and that'll be maybe easier for yourself to make up your mind about whether or not to go SLI. But for this video, we finished. Thanks, guys, for watching. If you liked the video, please click the like button and subscribe. And as always, have a nice day.